We are all different, yet we are all the same.
Jesus loves me, disciple. For the Bible tells me so. Little ones to him belong. They are weak, but he is strong. Yes, Jesus loves me. Yes, Jesus loves me. Yes, Jesus loves me. The Bible tells me so.
The seven last words from the cross are biblically attributed sayings of Jesus the Christ. These seven last words, gathered from the Bible's four Gospels, are presented through eyewitness accounts of his crucifixion. Today, you will be with me in paradise, is recorded at Luke 23:43 as the word of salvation. Ministered to one of two condemned thieves, salvation is being saved or protected from harm or being saved or delivered from a dire situation. In religion, salvation is understood to be the saving of the soul from sin and its consequences. Financial educators today might value salvation as a pathway to economic inclusion. Each person's interest compounds his or her own trust. Salvation comes from trusting Christ. It is as near as our own hearts and mouths. When you go to church, you might anticipate a lift that increases your value. As a saved soul, a kingdom asset, you tell others that Jesus Christ is your Lord and believe in your own heart that God raised him from the dead. So what happens next? We know that both thieves died on the cross, right? We've heard that one disciple took a bribe of 30 pieces of silver but never made it to the bank. We've been told that Jesus saved an adult entertainer known as Mary Magdalene, who became well known among his followers. In our daily lust for salacious details, we go to church on Good Friday, hoping to parse intimate details between the lines of good news. We peel our sick minds from current events such as Me Too, President and the Porn Star, and partisan politics, seeking enough information and motivation to practice what we preach. Salvation for the thief on the cross next to Jesus comes in his final hour. He's included. Salvation for Mary Magdalene came as Jewish men stoned her for her profession in adult entertainment. She's included. But what about Judas Iscariot, who may have given birth to the Me Too movement? Was he also saved?
It is the only way. Violence is the only language these Romans speak. It is foolish to think we could drive them out of Judea by spreading brotherhood and performing miracles. They laugh at us. But trust me, they will not laugh when they feel the sting of 1,000 Jewish swords.
And then what? They will send a whole army to overpower you.
Then we'll raise a big alarm.
This way was foretold by the scriptures, Judas. Do you doubt he is the Messiah?
I believe he may be. But it is his passive ways I find fault with.
Judas, he is a man of peace.
Peace won't drive out the Romans.
His way will succeed much faster than your army of zealots.
You say that only because it is easier to love a Messiah than a fisherman. What is it you see in him that is not in me?
The truth.
And here is my truth.
Fine. Would you like a feast your master has yet to enjoy?
At some point, truth will define the community that overcomes chaos. It was truth that saved Mary Magdalene from being stoned to death, truth that saved the repentant thief from condemnation, and truth that can lift 2.4 billion Christians to greater value in God's kingdom. Judas Iscariot, the disciple who betrayed Jesus, was so busy seeking alternative facts that he missed out on the good news. Salvation, he might have learned, is that life-changing value in good news. Salvation comes from trusting Christ, which means trusting God, which means connecting your trust to a community of beneficiaries. Trust is not always easy to achieve. For too many believers, trust loses value when our leaders lose sight of truth.
It is your job to keep the peace here in Armenia.
What are you trying to tell me?
My soldiers have arrested 4 troublemakers, so-called prophets. Do you understand me?
If I hear of someone else, I'll hand them over to you.
You have no power to arrest. How does it feel, a Jew handing over a Jew to Roman authorities?
It doesn't feel good. But my responsibility is to protect the law of our people, the law of God. And if I'm wrong, and one of those prophets is a real Messiah, let history judge me.